وصحبه ومن والاه. It is a given and it's known thing that if we believe in something, anyone who believes in something, it's a given that we will act according to this belief, or at least we will try to. And if we believe something is good for us, we'll try to attain that thing. And if we believe something is harmful or could cause us harm or put us at risk, it's also given that we will try to avoid that. We will avoid it as much as we can. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala highlighted to us in many verses of the Quran. And He told us that belief should be followed by the actions, by good deeds. And you will notice that it is frequently repeated in the Quran when Allah describes the believers as those who will do good, they will act. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. That they believe and do good deeds. So, belief without actions is deficient, is missing a lot. And actually it could be also futile. It could be false belief. If we believe and we don't try to implement this belief and do according to this belief. And the Imam today shared with us a few examples of that. The first, that we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is well aware of everything. Allah knows everything and nothing is hidden from His knowledge. This should result in acting according to this belief, that believing that Allah is watching over us and nothing is hidden from His knowledge, means that we will observe ourselves and our actions, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching over us whenever we do anything or we don't do something. Anyone before committing any sin or any violation should think, before I take this bribe or before I commit this crime, I need to make sure I hide it very well. I need to make sure no one will see me, and I need to make sure no one will know about it. And if I can guarantee that, do it. There are multiple examples. You know that example of the young man who was called for the committing adultery and fahisha, who was called for that, and that the place is safe, no one can see us. So he said, no one at all? Yes, no one. It's the place is closed, sealed, and no one can reach this place. He said, yes, but except one. All the doors are locked. Yes, except one door. It's the door of heaven. The door of the heaven is open. And Allah is watching over us. We cannot close that door. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's knowledge penetrating every barrier and goes to every place. It goes inside our hearts and our minds too. Those who want to commit crime, they need to think well before they do that. They could easily get away with this crime in this world, but not from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Allah is watching. Believing that Allah's knowledge is encompassing should stop us from committing sins and thinking of doing that. Thinking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Razzaq, is the sustainer, is the provider, should lead us to believe, to work, to gain our provisions and not to worry about anyone preventing us from getting our rizq, our provision. No one can stop you from getting a portion that Allah has decided for you. Like the Prophet ﷺ told the young man Ibn Abbas, he said, whatever hits you, no one can stop it. Whatever Allah has apportioned for you, no one can stop that from coming to you at all. So this should lead us to believe that our rizq is distant and no one can take it from us. No one will share it, even use. It will come to you 100%. No matter what they try to do. So this should lead us to work hard and not to give up hope. Ever, because Allah is Ar-Razzaq. Inna Allaha huwa Ar-Razzaqu dhul quwwati al-matin. Allah is the provider and Allah is the strong. That He wants something, He will do it, and no one can stop Him from doing that. Allah will do things through people, right? Allah can do things through the same people who wanted to hurt you. If He wants, He can make them provide for you. He can change their hearts, their minds, their directions. We can change our own minds, our hearts, and our directions too. Believing Allah is Ar-Razzaq, is the provider, is the sustainer, gives you comfort, gives the believer a comfort that our rizq is distant, it will come to you. So don't despair, don't give up hope, and don't be lazy. You should work hard, and Allah will give you the results of that. Also, relying in Allah. You believe in Allah, you rely on Him. Just like Musa alayhi salam, when he was chased by the Pharaoh, he and his people running away. They are leaving the country. They are running away. They are fleeing their lives from this tyrant. But he didn't want to let them go. He didn't leave them alone. He chased them with his armies. He wanted to leave the whole land, but he didn't want to let them go. He chased them. So he was almost catching them. They saw him. They are helpless people with their messenger, Musa. They are not armed with anything except their iman. Well, they're taking it and running away. But the Pharaoh is bringing his army and his soldiers and his weapons behind them. So they told Musa, Inna lamudrakun. He's catching us, O Moses. He's getting us. So Musa, the messenger, the believer, the strong leader, he said, Kalla, Inna ma'ya Rabbi sayahdeen. He said, no. Our Lord is with us. He will guide us and He will protect us. He will guide us and He will protect us. There was no way. In front of them soon is the sea, is the water. Behind them is the Pharaoh, and Allah saved them. In a story that is we all know, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Moses to hit the water with a stick, and water split, and there was a way for them to walk. But it was also for the Pharaoh to walk, right? For them, it was the way to save them. And for the Pharaoh, it was his destruction. This tyrant mentality, instead of seeing this miracle, should stop from his tyranny. He actually went on that he did this miracle. He himself did it. And Allah made it his end. And Allah made him an example. And until today, he's displayed. This Pharaoh is in display in Egypt. Sometimes they take him to display him in Paris or in other capital, because Allah said so. Allah said, I'm going to save you by your body, so you will be an example for those behind you. So please watch him or watch his photos from the Egyptian gallery. This is the Pharaoh who chased Moses and his people to destroy them. Allah said, I will destroy you and make you an example. اليوم ننجيك ببدنك لتكون لمن خلفك آية. And I'll make you an example for all those who come after you. And today, we are over 3,000 or 4,000 years after the Pharaoh, and we can see him and see this is the person who challenged Allah. This is the person who said, I'm the Lord. In my hand is your all souls and destiny. Allah said, no. Relying on Allah, when Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the same, just like Musa and his people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told his people, استعينوا بالله واصبروا, just like Musa told his people. When they were tortured by the Pharaoh and his people, he said, rely on Allah and practice patience. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told his people in Makkah, rely on Allah and practice patience. At a time when they took, when they were snatching his followers like Ammar and Yasir and Sumayya and Bilal, and they killed Yasir, they killed Sumayya, and they tortured Bilal and Ammar, the Prophet, and Khubayb, they put Khubayb on the cross. He told him, be patient, practice patience. The people before you, and he was referring to the followers of Isa alayhi salam, our beloved Prophet. They were actually tortured by the Romans and others, and they were patient and strong. He said, Wallahi, Allah will perfect his deen and complete this message. And Allah perfected his deen and completed his message. And few years later, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the same people came back to Mecca and declared it as a free country and the land of Tawheed, and cleaned Mecca from all the idols and removed all these statues and idols from Al-Kaaba. Relying on Allah, when Ibrahim alayhi salam was put on the machine to throw on the fire, he asked Allah for help. When Allah sent him the angel offering him help, he said, do you have any need, Ibrahim? He said, not from you, nothing from you. He's telling the angel. But from Allah, Allah knows best my situation. So Allah told the fire to be safe and calm and cool for Ibrahim. This is the same for all the believers. Believing in something, we should act on that. Whereas the hypocrites and the weak, Allah gave us example. Those who are weak in Iman, they rush to do otherwise. While the believers have strong belief in Allah and they love Allah more than anything else, and they seek help from Allah, those who are hypocrites and weak in Iman, فَتَرَى الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ يُسَارِعُونَ فِيهِمْ. They rush to seek help from the disbelievers, or they take them as friends and leave the believers aside. We have examples. Let's take example from before. Those who departed from the Muslims, from the Muslim army, and ran away because they didn't want to face the enemy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared them as hypocrites. They left the Prophet ﷺ and the messengers to face them alone. And this is repeating all the time. You will find people who are weak in Iman, who rush to cast deals with the enemies against the Muslims. Unfortunately. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to do our best. To rely on Allah. The Prophet ﷺ said, ما أمرتكم بِهِ فَأْتُوا مِنْهُ مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ. What I commanded you, what I'm commanding you to do, do as much as you can. And whatever I forbid you from doing, avoid it. Give it up. Don't do it. Right? This is the rule. This is the rule. Everyone should strive. Should strive and put their best effort to do the things Allah wants us to do. And seek help from Allah. Even to make salah, see, ask Allah to help you to do that. You want to make salatul fajr? Ask Allah to help you. Intend to wake up, Allah will help you. Even if you go to work, ask Allah for help so that you do your work properly, that you can gain reward for doing this. This could be normal work. You could be just a normal employee, accountant, a medical doctor, an engineer, consultant, any lawyer, anyone, right? But you go to work with this intention, you will do your work well, Allah will reward you for this, and people will like you for doing your job in the best way. This is the true belief, a reflection of the belief. You believe in these things, it should reflect in our actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes those who believe and do good deeds. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He promised paradise and reward, He promised those who work. وَنِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. He said this is the best reward for those who act, those who work, those who perform, not just believe. Belief by itself is not enough. We should intend to do as much as we can. We should do as much as we can. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us this great reward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the straight path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this land safe and peaceful. And all the lands, ameen ya rabbal alameen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala abdika wa nabiyyika Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi.
Thank you.